Zohar says that Paro, he wasn't a regular person. Paro is called in the Zohar Hatanim Hagadol. Also, the Navi calls him Hatanim Hagadol. He held himself like an idol. He turned himself into an idol. He said about himself, Li ye'ori v'ani asitini. He created the Nile River and he created himself. That's what Paro used to say about himself. And he ran the country and he ran the world like God. He thought of himself like this way. And the Zohar says he wasn't a regular person. He really had powers. And the Egyptians mostly used witchcrafts in order to control and to rule. And the slaves in Egypt, says Zohar, the way he describes it, they didn't have to close them in behind bars. Prisoners didn't have to close behind bars in Egypt. You didn't have to tie the hands, tie the leg, in order for them not to run away, not to escape. They used witchcrafts. They did kishufim, and they controlled them and locked them this way. You could see in Egypt, people, the prisoners, they're walking like zombies. They have no control over themselves. And if they want them to be locked down, they lock them down with the kishuf power. And Hazal described that they had special dogs around Mitzrayim, walking around. The dogs, they were full with witchcraft. If a slave was trying to escape from Mitzrayim, those dogs were jumping on him and tearing them apart. So they had powers. Mitzrayim had powers. Zohar explains that the kishuf, the tum'ah power, is divided to 10 kinds of power. Same as in the kedusha, we have also, as we know, ba'asara ma'amarot nivra ha'olam, the world was created with 10 sayings of Hashem. That's 10 sefirot that the Kabbalah is talking about. Zele umat ze asa elokim. Also, the Tum'ah has the same kinds of leadership, with divided to 10 powers. And therefore, Hashem Yitbarach gave 10 makot in Mitzrayim. The idea of 10 makot, each makah took away one of the power of Paro. Each makah showed, he thought that he controls, he thought that he's leading. And Hashem Yitbarach is coming and showing how this power is not yours. I'm controlling this power. And he's trying a different power. Hashem Yitbarach comes and shows that he's controlling this power. And therefore, Makat Bechorot, what's the Bechorot in Mitzrayim? Bechorot, they were the most important people in Mitzrayim. The priest, the important people. And the Pasuk says, Mi Bechor Paro Yoshev Akiso, Ad Bechor Hashevi Asher Bevet Abor. The Bechorot, the firstborns from Paro until the Bechor who sits in the prison. Vechol Bechor Behema. All the firstborns Hashem Yitbarach killed. Since Mitzrayim used the Bechorot in order to run the witchcrafts, says Zohar, if Hashem Yitbarach was not coming and taking apart those kishufim, no one in the world could have taken Am Yisrael out of Mitzrayim. Naturally, there was no way for us to leave Mitzrayim. They did it so good that there was no normal way to leave Mitzrayim. And Hashem Yitbarach himself came down in Mitzrayim and took apart and untied all the ties and all the kishufim that they did in Mitzrayim. And step by step, with the 10 makot, Hashem Yitbarach destroy the powers of this kohot ha-tum'ah and show the whole world that Hashem Yitbarach is controlling everything. Not just the side of the kedusha, but also the side of the tum'ah. It all runs by Hashem is willing. If Hashem wants it to work, it's going to work. If Hashem doesn't want it to work, it's not working. And therefore, Hag HaPesach is a special Hag. That shows that Hashem Yitbarach really, he's the one that controls everything, as Paro says himself. Ah, Hashem at Tzaddik. He knows that Hashem Yitbarach is running. Ata yadati ki gadol Hashem mikol ha'elohim. Who said this pasuk? Yitro said it. And who was Yitro? Yitro was Kohen Midian, was the top priest. We can say, like, compared to these days, maybe the Pope. Yitro was the Pope of those days. Yeah? And not only that he was a Pope of one religion, Yitro, Yitro was the top priest of all kinds of religions. He knew every idol in the world. He was an expert in every idol in the world. He knew the best way to worship those idols. And he understood the powers of the idols, how they run. And he said, "Ata yadati ki gadol Hashem mikol ha'elohim." If a Yehudi says it, it's a great praise to Hashem. But if a goy says it, and a goy, not a regular goy, Yitro, who was a priest, who was the top priest of all religions, of all idols, and he comes and admits that Hashem controls everything, and all the powers in the world are under Hashem's control, that That is a big shevach to Hashem Yitbarach. And that is the sipur of Yitziat Mitzrayim, Yiratzon, Shinzke, Shitkeim Banu, Kimetzetecha, Meretz Mitzrayim, Areinu, Niflaot, Amen, Ve'amen.